Taylor's going first. Opa, you go next. Okay. And then Susiana, you go third.
All right, morning class. How are you guys today?
Good.
Good. How are you? Good. All right, so we're first graders today. I'm going to start by just telling you our content objectives, okay? So today the students will be able to identify representations of fractions. That's our content. So we're going to be able to simplify, just identify simple fractions today, okay, class? Our language objectives are the student will be able to name the fractions that matches a picture that represents that fraction. So we're going to put the fractions with the picture shown, okay? That's what we're trying to achieve today. I'm going to go ahead and pass out our KWR charts. So what I know, what I wonder, and what I learned. So we're going to fill up first two columns today, okay? First two columns. So just what you think you know about fractions, what you want to know about fractions in that second column. And at the end of the class today, we're gonna fill out that last third chart as to what we learned today, okay? So go ahead and fill out those first two columns. Previous lessons that we've had with numbers and pictures, and think what you know about fractions, okay? Two columns, okay? Alright, does anybody want to share what they know about fractions already?
Numbers.
Good job! Does anybody want to share what they want to know about fractions, what they want to learn today?
How to add them.
Yes, okay, good job, girls. Alright, now I'm going to vocab that we're going to be focusing on today are fraction, denominator, and numerator, okay? So fractions are a part of a whole, and they have a denominator and numerator in it, okay? The denominator is the bottom number in the fraction, and that is the whole part of the fraction. It's how many equal parts are in that fraction. The numerator is the top part of the fraction, and it shows how many parts are represented in that one fraction, okay? I'm going to go ahead and we're going to do a class activity, okay? Everybody's going to get some flashcards. Okay, so first, everybody look up here on the board. We have a whole pizza, okay? We can divide this pizza into fractions. We have a whole pizza at first. We're going to look at the second pizza here. If I have two parts of the pizza, and I take one part away, what do I have left? Good job! That was awesome! Good job, guys. All right, now I have three parts of the pizza. If I take two away, what do I have left? Yeah! Awesome! All right, I have four parts of a pizza. If I take three away, what do I have left? You guys are awesome. That was so good. Good job. So that's what the fractions are. We have equal parts in each one, and we're trying to figure out what the fraction represents in each of those parts, okay? So we had a whole, and then we had a half. We have one-third, one-fourth, okay? We have those fractions, and that's what we use to represent how many pieces and parts are of the pizza, okay? The next thing that you guys were going to do is we're going to watch a little short video on fractions, just to introduce and give a little bit of a better explanation of what they are. All right.
equal part, quarters half thirds, or look at best parts. Of what did we name her? Well, we named the dog Fashion. How we could be blamed, it was just a reaction. Fashion caused trouble for my mom and me. Making parts out of things, everything she could see. She cut up our stuff into equal sized pieces. She cut up our skateboard, she cut up our pieces. We told her to stop, we told her to see. She said, I like everything, should be more than one piece. My doggy Fashion, she likes parts, she likes them when they're equal.
All right, you guys, so what do you think we got from that video? Why do you guys think that we use fractions? What did the puppy say about why we use fractions?
Good job, good job.
What are some ways that you can use fractions at home?
To tell time.
Yes.
To tell time.
One third of the circle and one fourth of the circle. done? The grade's finished? Alright, we're gonna go ahead and go over it. So, we're gonna use this as an example. What did the one half look like?
Did it look like
this?
Yes.
Good job, good job. Alright, the one third. Did it look like this?
Mm-hmm.
Good. And then the one fourth. That?
Yes.
Everyone do that correctly?
Yes.
Good job, class. That's awesome. Alright, so when you remember this at home that we're trying to divide those things into equal parts to make the one whole. So we have one half, which is half of a circle, one third of the circle, and one fourth of the circle, okay? We're gonna take a short quiz. This is gonna be on your own. You guys are gonna take this quiz, okay? Alright, so this quiz, you're gonna see what the colored area is, and then you're gonna pick from those fractions shown, and go ahead and pick which represents that picture, okay? We're gonna go ahead and finish out. You guys are gonna go to that KWR chart. We're gonna fill out the last column, okay? A very good column. You guys gotta fill this out to leave today. And the last column is what you guys learned today. So what you guys learned today about fractions? What do you think you know more about?